I'm going to wake you up this morning with a little story. This was a good number of years ago. And growing up, we had a really interesting, I guess, arrangement. When I was growing up, it was kind of a lot of freedom, things that we were doing that other kids, I only found out later that other kids didn't get to do some of the things that nobody stopped us from doing. But one of those things in our crazy adventures, among different things, we used to go on the roof, make these really big snowballs and roll them off, which would have been dangerous because it's all slick, etc. Other, really long bike rides, all kinds of sorts of things. But we had kind of an aggressive attitude towards having fun. So one of our little things was, came up with this really slick sleeping bag, and which has since been, I'm sure it was destroyed pretty soon after this, just because of how we were using it. But we took some camping mats. We have a sleeping bag and camping mats, and they're the little ones you can blow them up so they're nice and cushy. So we put two camping mats into the sleeping bag. They fit just perfect, and then put the sleeping bag at the top of the stairs. Now, the stairway we had carpet on it, had some good padding, and so, it was pretty much perfect. So what we'd do is we'd hop in the sleeping bag, ride down the stairs. We had our own roller coaster ride at home. And so here we are doing this, and we had a lot of fun doing that. But one day, I was, maybe I'd finished my schoolwork, it was homeschooled, and I decided, I'm going to have some fun now. So I hopped in as usual, but this time something went wrong. So I was going down the stairs, I leaned forward too much, and my foot caught one of the stairs when I was almost towards the bottom. I was, I'm just guessing it was probably a 6 or 7 foot drop as I hit, but my foot caught, went face forward, did a belly flop right at the bottom of the stairs. And I got the wind knocked out of me really, really bad. But I remember thinking that, oh no, I'm going to die. Because I hadn't had that happen before. Couldn't breathe. It's like, felt like I was going to suffocate. But nonetheless, was it the end of the world for me at that point? No. But as we talk today in this old gospel about the end of the world, there are two ways of looking at it. We know that, yes, there's a lot that can be known about the end of the world, but what I'd like to focus about is the end of our world. The end of our life. Because that really, that's the more practical question of, do we know if we're going to make it that far or not? And there's just so much that we don't know. But we do know that one day we shall die. Another thing, another little instance that I thought was really funny. And we see this, we see it very often. Once I had a bloody nose, and it was really, really, really bad. I've never had a bloody nose that bad before. I started to feel like I was going to, trying to do everything, nothing was stopping it. Felt like I was going to bleed out and maybe die. Of course, I have a big imagination, so you see a danger where there's nothing really there at all. But thinking through that, it's amazing the thought process that starts going through your mind, thinking of, maybe I could die. Of all the different things that come to mind. But the funny thing was, with this instance, was I started feeling really, really happy. It's like, hey, I'm dying now. This isn't that bad. Think of, try, and that's the way it should be. If we're trying to live a good life, do everything we can to know, love, and serve God so we can be happy with Him forever in heaven. What a joy that can be. The joy to realize that we're getting close to our goal. We're reaching it. Now, I was kind of disappointed, a little bummed out, realizing, it wasn't as bad as I thought. I was just really dehydrated and I needed more water. But nonetheless, those thoughts going through, what a beautiful meditation that is. Sometimes in the winter months, I find it, I don't know if this is something everybody deals with, but I find it quite difficult to, it's dark frequently, and it's kind of hard to keep yourself going, find things to do when it's cold and wet outside, and all that sort of thing. One thing that really helped me is I started making a list of a little laptop. I mean, get those big sticky note things that they have on there, and I write a list out of all the things that I know I need to be accomplishing, things that Father asked me to do, and all the different jobs. And so I have that list up there, and difficulty is I'll get halfway through the day and then I finish something and I'm kind of just wandering around. It's always that temptation to maybe go check my emails 5 times a day, which doesn't make any sense. Why bother? Nobody emails me anyways unless they need something. But it's just a difficulty sometimes to avoid the sloth there, that sort of thing. So what I was thinking was, okay, I'm going to make this list and put everything on that list that I want. And then every time I get bored, I go look at the list. And then I start thinking of what I need to do. It was a really, really big help. Especially when everything on your list is boring and it's very difficult to do. Like right now I'm working on a little carport deal and there's concrete on these boards and I'm trying to get the concrete off so I can just use some of the scrap woods to help, help make ends meet and that sort of thing. But it's not my favorite thing to do by any means. But nonetheless, it's those reminders. But I also like to think of that thought. And it's a good thought for each and every one of us to think. How do I want to live my life? What are the kinds of things that I want to have accomplished when I get to my deathbed? What do I want to be there? What are the regrets going to be? Or what are the great happinesses that will come from the crosses that I carried faithfully? The difficulties that I overcome? So, and all that sort of thing. So as we think of that, the end of our life, the end of our little world, what do we want? What do we want that to be? What a beautiful thought. Think of it every day. Wake up in the morning and think of, okay, what are my goals? And like I said, I think it's easier to write them down and have it somewhere where when you forget about them, because it's so easy to forget everything, if you forget about it, you can always go back and then remind yourself of, oh, yes, it's this, and it's this. But we know God made us to know, love, and serve Him. Our time is so short, so very short. It's just a little while. And all the temporal things around us pass away. It's also neat to think of, we see in today's gospel, how that let him who reads understand that those who are in Judea flee to the mountains, let him who is on the housetop not go down to take anything from his house, and let him who is in the field not turn back to take his cloak. And how often it is with those who do not love God, generally they end up loving the material things around them to an excess. And those are the things that they're thinking about, and that's what makes them so sad. They have to leave their home. They have to leave these things that they spent their whole life acquiring. And all those things will be taken away from them forever. And they didn't put their money, so to speak, in the proper bank. If they were only thinking of the goodness and love of God and trying to please Him and making that their number one goal, then all these things, death, which can bring so much sadness and distress, would instead bring nothing but peace and joy. So as we think of God and we think of heaven, let us remember that we are made for a better place. There's that beautiful place called heaven. Think of the company of the people who are there. Jesus, we get to receive Him in Holy Communion and we get to spend time with Him every time we come to Mass and receive Communion, and what a privilege that is, and the strength that we find in that. But think of how much more it must be to behold Him face to face in heaven. Same thing with the Blessed Virgin Mary. What a joy we say the rosary every day. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. We think of the strength, the grace that we find to overcome so many difficulties in that beautiful rosary. But boy, what must it be to be able to actually be there, right in her presence, to see her, to honor her, and to, with her, praise God for all eternity. So as we think of these things, and remember, don't go downstairs in a sleeping bag. It's not a good idea. It could speed up the end of your world. But nonetheless, as we think of the end of the world, God does have a will for it at some point in time. And then when that comes, we want to be prepared so that Jesus will also say to us, "Come, ye good and faithful servant, you've been faithful over a few things. And now I'll place you over my entrance to the joy of your Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.